My name is Vidyadhar, T. Vidyadhar. I am more deeply concerned with the environment, and incidentally, the Hebbal Lake was a very bad lake. It was very badly. Nobody bothered about it, and we were involved in the regeneration of the Hebbal Lake. The initial pushing the government to develop this regeneration plan, it went from us. Then we had a park, beautiful park was made. And Oberoi, unfortunately, they were watching the development is happening quietly, and once the development took place, they wanted to take over and to maintain that. Privatization per se, it is not bad, but we should have a good monitoring system. We should know what we want from them. We have not given them the what is required out of the water. See, you have to maintain the quality of the water, particularly quality of the water, what is the fish life, what is the bird life, is there any migratory birds are coming, if not coming, why, reasons. Public should be able to enter the park. We suggested that they should not increase the rate of entry.
Land around the tanks, which are now called lakes, are very valuable from a real estate point of view, and they've been built up in several parts of the city. So what happened was, the government decided, let's have a specialized agency to look at lakes and develop them because of the changing scenario of the city and the lakes in Bangalore, and also lakes in other parts of the state. So the LDO set up from that point of view. The LDO's body consisted of people from all these different agencies. They said that they did not have sufficient resources, in financial resources as well as human resources, to manage so many lakes in Bangalore. So for them, the alternative was to privatize it, outsource the management and maintenance of the lakes to private bodies, and they will earn money in the process. And the work started in full-fledged manner, primarily in Nagawara, where Lumbini developers kind of took it over. So it's called Lumbini Gardens now. But what has happened is, they have redone the shore of the lake. You have all these food courts and amusement games and all that on one side. The lakes will be leased out to private bodies for a period of 15 years for a certain amount.
तालाब का मेंटेनेंस कर रहा है फिशरीज पकड़ने वाला आदमी को वो भेजने को वो इंचार्ज में काम कर रहा है लुम्बिनी गार्डन आने के बाद पूरा फेंसिंग डाल दिया और बोटिंग कर दिया और होटल मैनेजमेंट होटल स्विमिंग पूल और बच्चों का खेलने का वही कमर्शियल में काम कर रहा है उन्हें वो प्राइवेटाइज करने तो एक ही आदमी का होता है धंधा पूरा धंधा एक ही आदमी का होता है वो कमर्शियलाइज करे तो एंट्री फीस का 80 रुपये ले रहा है अभी बोटिंग करने को एक आदमी को 100 रुपये ले रहा है एक काफ़ी को 60 रुपये 80 रुपये ले रहा है वैसे कमर्शियलाइज ज़्यादा होता है तालाब का राउंड से वॉकिंग ट्रैक नहीं बना दिए उन्हें फिर से फ्री एंट्री नहीं दे रहा एंट्री होने तो 80 रुपये दे के आने को पानी देखना हमको 5 साल का लीज में देता है लीज का पैसा 1 साल का 3 लाख पड़ता है और साल में 5% इंक्रीज करके देना उनका एक ही आदमी का धंधा है ना वो बढ़ जाता है गरीब हो गरीबी भी रहता है इसलिए
there is a thriving fishing community in Bangalore which depends on lakes for their livelihood. So what has happened is, even though in the agreement, especially for Nagawara Lake, their rights were supposed to be maintained, but the agency which took, I mean the corporate which took them, took the lake over, that is Lumbini Developers, they didn't allow access for the local fishermen, local fishing association, to continue their fishing in the lake. And they had to struggle a bit for a year or two and run a campaign to get their rights back. Right now they are fishing, but they are allowed to fish only in certain timings of the day. That has limited their access to the lake also. So that has affected their fishing activities.